India is developing its infrastructure at an immense pace and has reached close to top spots in the world for certain infrastructure markers. India ranks second in the world for its road network, third in the world in terms of electricity produced and consumed, and fourth in the world for its rail network. But India's ranks for other infrastructure markers are not that good. India ranks 55th as per the International Civil Aviation Organization's Aviation Safety Oversight Rankings and ranks 69th in terms of the median mobile speed globally. India has the world's largest population of approximately 142 crores, and having this huge population have both pros and cons. The obvious pros are greater economic growth due to higher generation of goods and services which can be traded with other countries, huge tax collection, more human resources for jobs, more workforce for military, huge consumer market domestically, etc. But the cons of huge population can be seen in the rankings of India. Across the infrastructure markers when compared with top 5 and bottom 5 nations in terms of GDP per capita of G20. Starting with the mobile networks, the share of population that uses internet when compared to other 9 nations put India into a very tight spot. Only 43% of Indian population uses internet. The closest neighbor is Indonesia, where 62% of the population uses internet. In the top 5 countries, around 90% of the population uses internet. The same pattern emerges when the number of mobile subscriptions per 100 people is seen. In India, 82 subscriptions per 100 people is there, whereas all other countries have this figure beyond 100 subscriptions per 100 people. Surprisingly, Canada is the only other country in this list to have mobile subscriptions less than 100 people. But don't get fooled by these numbers. 43% of Indian population is approximately 61 crores, whereas 92% of Canada's population is only 3.5 crores. Further, the total mobile subscriptions in South Africa are only 10 crores as compared to 116 crores in India. But the huge population of India pushes it back to lower rankings. In terms of domestic air passengers, India performs poorly. Only 10.1 people per 100 people in India travels by airplanes domestically. The nearest neighbor, surprisingly, being Germany, where only 28.6 people per 100 people travels through airplanes domestically. The main reason here is the lower per capita income in India and better and inexpensive connectivity through rail and road. The same can be seen in other countries too. Germany has 6th largest rail network and 13th largest road network in the world, making the travel through rail and road easier and inexpensive. You must have heard about the famous the Autobahn, the federal controlled access highway system in Germany. Australia, Canada and USA have the large geographical area where connectivity through passenger rail and road network is not good. USA uses most of its rail network for good transshipment, and in fact rail travel costs more as compared to air travel. Canada and USA have similar reasons for preferring air travel over any other mode of transport. Canada and Australia have major portion of their land barren, hence there is basically low connectivity through rail or road in these countries. Rail passengers kilometers per capita is one of the highest in India. In fact, even with the world's largest population, India managed to be at the 4th position in this list with 858 kilometers traveled by each passenger. Germany and France, with a lesser rail connectivity than India, managed to be at the top spot in the chart just because of their lesser population. India has an installed capacity of 410.3 gigawatt for electricity generation, which makes it the third largest electricity producer and consumer in the world after China and USA. But the huge population plays a negative role here too. The per capita electricity generation for India is 1218 kilowatt hour only, whereas for the similar population, China has the per capita electricity generation of 5950 kilowatt hour. No doubt about that, since the installed capacity of the country is 2564.1 gigawatt, almost 6 times that of India. India surpasses only Indonesia in this list. In terms of roads, India ranks second in the world but tops the chart with 193 kilometers of road per 100 square kilometer. The closest competitor is France, which has 192.3 kilometers of road per 100 square kilometer. Only Germany comes close to this number with 178.9 kilometers of road per 100 square kilometer. Rest all countries have this number below 100. The roads crisscrossing India make for one of the densest mobility networks in the world. India is far ahead of China and Brazil on road length per square kilometer, and only the likes of France and Germany comes close among the top G20 economies. As for railways, the number of people making train journey in India is much higher than many emerging as well as many industrialized countries. To speed ahead in the digital age, the country needs to invest in power generation and achieve a higher penetration of internet and mobile phones. This is all for today's episode. I hope that you have liked it. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more of such videos. See you in the next episode. Till then, take care.